Let me introduce you to Dr. V.N. Bedekar, Institute of Management, in a more rigorous way. V.N. Bedekar, who had a big dream of creating a fantastic institution when you talk about management arena, because during that time, management education was flourishing, and he did create a great institution. Thanks to his son, Mr. Vijay Bedekar, who again put in a lot of energy, a lot of enthusiasm, a lot of contribution, in terms of thought process and leadership. And they created a good platform where we could nurture a lot of professionals in the area of management. When I joined this institution, I was not aware of this institution much. But when I landed here, I thought that it is a great place when you talk about the infrastructure, fantastic infrastructure, or I would say state-of-the-art infrastructure when you talk about technology, state-of-the-art infrastructure when you talk about the convenience and the size of the classrooms, the latest tools when you talk about teaching learning. And all this makes a great learning place. I would give credit, a lot of credit to the faculty members, because I have always been thinking that soul of any institution is the faculty members. Unless and until you have a great soul, probably a great body may not help. So for an institution to be a great, you need to have a great soul. And we have some fantastic faculty base. When I talk about faculty base, I would say that roughly 20% of my faculties today are either pass out of IIMs or IITs. So that gives me a good leverage when you talk about their understanding about how a great management education or great management institute can be shaped. I have other faculty members who have rich experience from the corporate and industry. They contribute a lot in terms of bringing relevance, because relevance is another important thing when you talk about BRIMS. The third important connotation which I would like to bring in is the emotional part of it, because we have a lot of faculties who understand students better, who understands the thought process of the students. And one thing which we have done at Dr. V.N. Bedekar Institute of Management, which is so prominent, is we are trying to understand how adults learn and how adults learn better. Because only when we understand how they learn, probably it will be easier for us to impart education their way. The students who are coming here, we have thanks to students who have come right from Kandivali, Goregaon side also. And I still wonder why students have to move from Thane to South Bombay or other institutes in Bombay. Because I think the kind of knowledge, the kind of education, the kind of environment we have, and the kind of overall learning experience which one can have at V.N. Bedekar is going to be extremely different, and it is going to be unique. So we are not restricting our education to classrooms. We are saying that learning can be beyond classroom. Learning can be on digital platform, learning can be on playground, learning can be in the classroom, learning can be during the fun. So we can create learning atmosphere in every nook and corner of the system. I would request that people should visit our Facebook to understand how we are trying to shape the student as a total professional. So this is where I think Dr. V.N. Bedekar Institute of Management can shape the future of the Thane and of the students who are joining this institution. See, everybody who stays in Thane and around may not be in a position to complete or invest his 2 years, and therefore we thought that can we also cater to them. And when I say catering to them, I thought, can we create some programs which are going to be more meaningful and can support them in their career? And with this thought process, we thought, can we have a small program which is an 11 months program, could be on Saturday-Sunday basis, and we created a program called PGP, which is postgraduate program in management. This program caters to a big chunk of students, which talks about which takes care of the HR part of it, the marketing part of it, the finance part of it, or the IT part of it, or even the marketing or sales part of it. Second program, which is so important and close to our heart, is the digital marketing program. Now, means I don't have to tell that why we have introduced digital marketing program in this digital era, where everything is going digital, even our transactions are going to be 100% digital over a period of time. So when I say all that, I'm saying the digital need for digital marketing is very high. People need to understand that it is not about only Facebook, it is not about only the social media part of it. How people need to use the keywords, how need they need to understand the how that search engine works and all that parameters, which will enable them to brand their product or institution, or probably enable them to create enough of awareness about their product. And this is one program which is again being handled by thorough professionals from the industry, and thanks to them for supporting us in that arena. The other important program which we thought could be very useful for everybody, because everybody may not be hooked up with digital and they need some work and they need enough of skills, and we thought of creating a supply chain management program. Because when we talk about the relevance of the industry, the way industry is shaping up and the way things are moving on to online platform, the only industry which is still there, which is there on the ground, is the supply chain. And when I'm saying supply chain, I'm not talking about only the transport or the logistics, I'm talking about end-to-end supply chain management. So when I'm saying end-to-end supply chain management, I think the need of professional is in lakhs. And thanks to our own location, because Thane is very strategically located when you talk about the geographic location of Thane. So on one hand, you see the Bhiwandi, which is flooded with warehouse. On the one side, we see Thane Wagle Industrial Estate, which is again flooded with a lot of SMEs and MSMEs. Similarly, we have on one side Airoli and Gansoli and Rabale kind of industrial areas. On the other side, if we say the Ambarnath kind of industry. So we are very strategically located to cater to all these organizations which are there, and we wish to support them. So everybody who is doing MBA may not be joining them, but we have small programs. People can do those programs and enrich themselves with a lot of skills, can grow in life with those skills and be professional and be happy. I'm happy to share with you some of the major achievements which BRIMS has in the recent time. One major which we really felt was major was BRIMS was awarded by DNA as one of the best B school when you talk about innovative marketing styles. The DNA and their team identified us as one of the best when you talk about the B schools parameters, and we thank them for awarding or rewarding us with that kind of award. Second important thing which did happen, and we participated in one of the rankings, and by CSR, this is a competition success review, and they has ranked us in the category of excellence. In the category of excellence, we have been ranked as top B schools, and again, I was wondering how it is happening and why it is happening, but I think we are also doing a lot of work when you talk about why should we not be ranked there. And I'm happy to share that we are working very closely with the industry, and when I say industry, we are doing a program, a professional development program for the professionals at Pitambri Products Private Limited Company, which is a Thane based company. We have been also requested by Adisha Electronics, which is again a company, Thane based company, to take care of one year management program for them. So I think this support is coming in thanks to the opportunities in the market, and we created some consulting programs. I myself consulted a company called Chembond Chemicals Limited on sales process management and business excellence. Again, when I say our own PGDM program, and we have a vision of creating global citizens. So thanks to our top management, and they have allowed us to take our students to Singapore. So around 40 students from PGDM batch are going to visit Singapore, and they are definitely going to learn a lot. I'm saying right from the discipline at the airport, and I'm saying the discipline at their industry, and on the street, I think. So overall, probably it is going to be a big experience, a big learning experience for our budding managers of tomorrow. And I'm sure this is going to reshape their life, reshape their thinking process. And I'm definite that a lot of leadership skills will be harnessed during this process. Again, we have Dr. Guru Prasad Murthy here, who is again a big, probably a legend when you talk about management thought process, ex-director Jamnalal Bajaj. Myself and probably I would say Dr. Guru Prasad Murthy, and then myself, we did a program with CII which was into business excellence. And probably it was a fantastic program on understanding the European Quality Foundation Management System. So this was purely with the thought process of what is business excellence today, how organizations are moving towards that zone of excellence. And thanks to CII, which had appointed me as an assessor for RPG Group Company, and we did probably a good job there. So this is what we are doing. It is not that we are just restricting ourselves to the classroom. We are moving out of the box. We are moving on the edges of the box. We do not wish to be totally out of the box. We wish to be on the edges of the box, that we see what is happening outside the institution and also what is happening in the institution, inside the institution. So the story is that we are trying to build, rebuild and restructure. Today, you will all agree that technology is playing a very, very important role. When I say very, very important role, it is very, very still two terms or two jargons which are trying to support, but I am saying the entire industry is moving towards digital. When that is moving towards digital, and the entire current business functions are brick and mortar kind of thing. So there is a need that ideas need to marry. And when I say ideas need to marry, it is not about just saying that, the ideas or the applications have to marry. And this is the effort which we are talking about, how the management education can reshape, rethink, and how can we create leadership in that domain so that the students who pass out should be in a position to drive the industry, should be in a position to guide the industry, and probably create a name for himself and for the institution. Some of the skills which we are definitely focusing along with this technology part of it is the critical thinking skills, the situational leadership skill, the skills which are into analytics, because we also know that one of the hottest jobs in the market will be going to be analytics or data scientist. The other parameter which is in line with our thought process of our Honorable Prime Minister is all about creating entrepreneurs. So we are working very closely with SIDBI, which is where we say that can we really create people who can create more employment rather than they becoming employees. So that is another area we are focusing on, and that is entrepreneurship. So we have created a startup program, and we are trying to nurture them in the areas of thought process. When you talk about how to start up your own business, how to get funding, what are the rules and regulations and laws and bylaws, so that you can shape things. And we have a project system which is going, means the student has to undergo a big project, understand the project, recreate things, recreate the thought process, discuss, and it is a 6 months long program which will enable the students to develop themselves as a good entrepreneurs in the marketplace.